RealMe launches the RealMe GT globally, Windows 11 leaks, the Xiaomi Mi 10T Pro gets the MIUI 12.5 update, and Honor sells their first phone with Google Mobile Services since the Huawei ban. What's up, guys? It is Friday. It means the weekend is almost here, and I want to go ahead and give you guys the weekly news. Now, if you guys want to stay up to date with more of these stories as they happen, go ahead and check out Techfluent. And as always, the Friday news is sponsored by Surfshark VPN. Wait till the end of this video for an exclusive offer I have for you guys. Now, first up is the RealMe GT, coming in at a shocking introductory price of 369 euros, which is right around 380 bucks. RealMe is launching this exclusively through AliExpress, and I'll have a link to where you can go ahead and pre-order the RealMe GT, as the price is going to go up considerably after pre-orders, and the only place that you can buy it currently on pre-order is through AliExpress. So check the link down below for that. But some specs of it: Snapdragon 888, 65 watt super dark charging. It's the same split battery cell design. It's got a 4,500 milliamp hour battery, by the way, as all of the other BBK flagship devices, with a 0 to 100% full charge in right around 35 minutes. 120 hertz Super AMOLED display with a 360 hertz touch sampling rate. It's not an OTPL panel, but it is a top of the line flagship display. I think that the RealMe GT is in some ways a better flagship killer, although it's still lacking in a lot of areas in regards to the cameras, with no OIS, a potato ultra wide, and a macro camera. But you get the Snapdragon flagship SoC, you get the flagship super dark charging, which has a split battery cell design, which Xiaomi is not giving you on the Redmi K40 Pro, as well as a flagship display, or a close to flagship display at least, even though it's not the OTPL panel that the OnePlus 9 Pro and OPPO Find X 3 Pro. I can't keep these devices straight. But you get three basic flagship features on this top of the line device at under 400 euros. I think it's a great deal. If you want me to review it, let me know in the comment section down below. Next up, we have Windows 11 being leaked and being available for download. Some people over on my Discord community had that, and if you guys want to chat on my Discord for this stuff, you can go ahead and do that. We are also sharing Windows keys for activation on there. But essentially, we have rounded corners, no more live tiles, but we have widgets, and we have a lot of Mac OS design elements, like the programs going into specific corners of the display for multitasking, which is something that I have and I like on my Mac Mini M1. Link to my review of the Mac Mini up here. Next up is the Xiaomi Mi 10T Pro begins to get the MIUI 12.5 update. Now, I have talked about the Mi 10T Pro before, and I'll link to whatever video I have about that up here. Mi 10T Pro, really great device, and in 2021, it's actually a very compelling device with a flagship camera from the last year flagship, the Xiaomi Mi 10, a good ultra-wide camera, a 144 hertz LCD display, a 5,000 milliamp hour battery, and the same charging tech that we have on the Poco X3, as well as the Xiaomi Mi 11X. So you're really not compromising on a whole lot, and you're getting a great camera with the Mi 10T Pro. And the fact that it's getting the MIUI 12.5 update is nice. In my personal experience with MIUI 12.5, and link to those videos up here, I had on average around an extra gigabyte of available RAM, which is a nice thing because you are then able to pin more apps open. But if you guys want to watch videos about MIUI 12.5 optimizations, I'll have that video up here. Now, it seems like Xiaomi has been hearing out all of our cries that MIUI sucks. In fact, I did a whole video about MIUI sucking, link to that video up here, and you guys agreed that MIUI is very meh. But Xiaomi has launched a Mi Explorer program, but this seems like it's only for China, which is focused on finding bugs and fixing bugs in MIUI. I don't know how much of this is actually going to end up with a better MIUI experience for all you guys, or whether, there goes my computer, or whether or not this is just Xiaomi trying to apologize for their ad-filled, bloaty, power-hungry software. Next up, we have the Honor 50. Now, the Honor 50 is a little bit more complicated. The Honor 50 is the first phone launched by Honor since Honor and Huawei separated into separate companies due to the Google Mobile Services ban that was put on Honor Huawei about a year and a half ago because the US government had information that Huawei was putting backdoors into some of their routers and into some of their networking equipment. But the Honor 50 has a Snapdragon 778, and they're also going to be launching another version with the Dimensity 900. It's going to be having a 50 megapixel camera, and really, who cares about that? Do you guys still want to buy Huawei or Honor devices now? Now, bonus one for you guys is Pete Lau says that OnePlus is deepening its ties with OPPO. Now, whether or not we see a complete integration of Oxygen OS and Color OS, Color OS, into the OnePlus ecosystem is left up to be seen. We have seen a bunch of features from Color OS make their way into Oxygen OS. We have seen some of the animations and overall aesthetic from Oxygen OS make its way into Color OS. And we know now that the R&D departments of OnePlus and BBK are now in the same building under one roof. Whether or not we are going to continue to see OnePlus basically making OPPO devices for a Western market is something that is probably not going to change anytime soon, but it's still kind of weird to see OPPO and BBK and OnePlus just kind of merge into one, whereas OnePlus devices used to be the Lineage OS custom ROM loving devices that we all wanted. As always, the Friday news is brought to you guys by Surfshark VPN. Now, Surfshark VPN is the VPN that I know and use here in Vietnam. Here in Vietnam, my Netflix is limited to a bunch of very specific content. My music choices here are kind of limited, as well as stuff like certain music on TikTok, which is really, really weird. Surfshark VPN unlocks all that for me. On top of that, when having to deal and connect with US-based websites, my internet speeds are actually increased when using Surfshark VPN. And when I chatted with some of you guys on Discord in India or other countries that have internet censorship, you guys said the same thing, that sometimes, for specific cases, using a VPN actually speeds up your internet connection. So depending upon where in the world you live, Surfshark VPN might be an absolutely awesome offer, as it is one of the cheapest VPNs on the market. And for my viewers, we have a special 83% discount along with a 30-day money-back guarantee, and it goes a long way to supporting this channel. If you guys want to try Surfshark VPN 100% risk-free, go ahead and check out my affiliate links down below. If you guys want to keep up with me online, go ahead and check out my Twitter. It's where I love to contact and interact with you guys. And until next time, it's been Mitchell for the Friday News. Take the weekend easy. You deserved it. Peace.